using an inexpensive polymer called melamine, the main component of Formica, chemists have created a cheap, easy and energy-efficient way to capture carbon dioxide from smokestacks, a key goal for the United States and other nations as they seek to reduce greenhouse gas emissions. The process for synthesizing the melamine material, published in the journal Science Advances, could potentially be scaled down to capture emissions from vehicle exhaust or other movable sources of carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide from fossil fuel burning makes up about 75% of all greenhouse gases produced in the US. The new material is simple to make, requiring primarily off-the-shelf melamine powder, which today costs about $40 per ton, along with formaldehyde and cyanuric acid, a chemical that, among other uses, is added with chlorine to swimming pools. The so-called melamine porous network captures carbon dioxide with an efficiency comparable to early results for another relatively recent material for carbon capture, metal organic frameworks or MOFs. UC Berkeley chemists created the first such carbon capture MOF in the year 2015, and the subsequent versions have proved even more efficient at removing carbon dioxide from flue gases such as those from a coal-fired power plant. But Haiyan, a UC Berkeley postdoctoral fellow who is first author of the paper, said that melamine-based materials use much cheaper ingredients, are easier to make, and are more energy efficient than most MOFs. The low cost of porous melamine means that the material could be deployed widely. This work creates a general industrialization method towards sustainable CO2 capture using porous networks. The researchers hope they can design a future attachment for capturing car exhaust gas, or maybe an attachment to a building, or even a coating on the surface of furniture. While eliminating fossil fuel burning is essential to halting climate change, a major interim strategy is to capture emissions of carbon dioxide, the main greenhouse gas, and store the gas underground or turn CO2 into usable products. The US Department of Energy has already announced projects totaling $3.18 billion to boost advanced and commercially scalable technologies for carbon capture, utilization and sequestration, CCUS, to reach an ambitious flue gas CO2 capture efficiency target of 90%. The ultimate US goal is net zero carbon emissions by 2050. But carbon capture is far from commercially viable. The best technique today involves piping flue gases through liquid amines, which bind CO2. But this requires large amounts of energy to release the carbon dioxide once it's bound to the amines, so that it can be concentrated and stored underground. The amine mixer must be heated to between 120 and 150 degrees Celsius to regenerate the CO2. In contrast, the melamine porous network with the DITA and the cyanuric acid modification captures CO2 at about 40 degrees Celsius, slightly above room temperature, and releases it at 80 degrees Celsius, below the boiling point of water. The energy savings come from not having to heat the substance to high temperatures. In its research, the Berkeley Stanford Texas team focused on the common polymer melamine, which is used not only in Formica, but also in expensive dinnerware and utensils, industrial coatings and other plastics. Treating melamine powder with formaldehyde, which the researchers did in kilogram quantities, creates nanoscale pores in the melamine that the researchers thought would absorb CO2. The researchers said that tests confirmed that formaldehyde-treated melamine absorbed CO2 somewhat, but absorption could be much improved by adding another amine-containing chemical, a DITA, that is diethylene triamine, to bind CO2. She and her colleagues subsequently found that adding cyanuric acid during the polymerization reaction increased the pore size dramatically and radically improved CO2 capture efficiency. Nearly all the carbon dioxide in a simulated flue gas mixer was absorbed within about 3 minutes. The addition of cyanuric acid also allowed the material to be used over and over again. The researchers conducted solid-state nuclear magnetic resonance NMR studies to understand how cyanuric acid and DITA interacted to make carbon capture so efficient. The study showed that cyanuric acid forms strong hydrogen bonds with the melamine network that helps stabilize the tar, preventing it from leaching out of the melamine pores during repeated cycles of carbon capture and regeneration. The researchers are continuing to tweak the pore size and amine groups to improve the carbon capture efficiency of melamine pores networks while maintaining the energy efficiency. This involves using a technique called dynamic combinatorial chemistry to vary the proportions of ingredients to achieve effective, scalable, recyclable, and high-capacity CO2 capture.